Hello boys and girls. This video we're going to show off a little bit with the Retron 3 that I recently purchased. And I'm going to show you the community build that I put in it. Basically what that is was the programming for the Retron 77 is kept on a micro SD card. I basically took the original out, bought another micro SD card, went online and downloaded on Atari Age what is called a community build. And there are plenty of YouTube videos to show exactly how to do it. What I'm going to show today is the result. Alright, here we go. Let me dim the lights. There, that's better. Alright. So, as you can see, we have a directory. Games with the title first letter A through G, then H through R, then S through Z. We'll go ahead and start with A and G. And as you can see, once you click, there's just a wide range of Atari 2600 games. And some of them, and we'll put this one on real quick, I'm not going to click on it. You can see cut underneath there, you can see Custer's Revenge. Yes, it even has the X-rated games. So I still haven't figured out if there's a way without turning the machine off and back on to get to the other two. So I'm just going to go ahead and do it. Okay, and Houston, we have a problem. Let's try that again. There we go. All right, let's go to the second one, because I want to show you something else here. Just look at all of those games. Oh, you got a lot of European PAL games on here that you wouldn't normally be able to own. And there's just hundreds of games in this program. And even prototypes like this right here, Mysterious Thief. Don't know if you can play the prototypes yet, if they're actually a game or just some screenshots, because I just installed this yesterday and I have basically just begun to scratch the surface. You can see here it's Phaser Patrol. This was a game on the Starpath Supercharger, for those of you who are familiar with that. And all of these Starpath games are on here that I can see. This particular game, to play it, I'm going to go ahead and click on it, but you need the second joystick plugged in, which I don't have it plugged in right now. But you can get the general idea. See, I need the second joystick to get off of this screen here, which I don't have. But it looks and plays just like the original. I don't think I have the newest version of the community build, because I've seen others with numbers at the top that are higher than mine, but in any event, here's S through Z. You can see all the games here. I mean, like I said, there's just hundreds of them. You got all the Star Wars games. It's just incredible. And Steeplechase, this is a game right here that you play with the paddle controller, and it is getting very expensive. The Sears, Roebuck and Company games that were exclusive to Sears, that Atari made just for Sears, are getting hugely expensive. Matter of fact, I wonder if Submarine Commander's on here. Let's check. And here it is. This game was another Sears Roebuck exclusive game, and they are getting incredibly expensive on eBay. Never played this before, so there we go. Now obviously this is an early game, came out in the late 70s. So as you can see, the graphics aren't as good as they could be, but it's nice to have an exclusive game. So anyway, that, ladies and gentlemen, is the community build for the Hyperkin Retron 77. Oh, and here's one more game real quick before I end this. There's another game that's getting incredibly expensive. This is 20th Century Fox's Alien, which is basically a Pac-Man clone. Let's go ahead and play it for just a second here. It even has the Pac-Man music. And basically what you're doing is you're collecting the alien eggs. Oh. And every once in a while, there you go, this is a flamethrower. If you can get turned in the direction of the monsters, you can hit them with the flamethrower, and it basically just makes them turn in the other direction. And of course, when you eat the little shiny things, whatever those are, I don't even know what they are. There we go, we're going to get that flamethrower again. Well, damn it, missed it. And it only stays on the screen for a few seconds, so I like how it has the pass-throughs. So anyway, there you have it right there. Matter of fact, I just spent $30 buying this game. See, there's your flamethrower, but anyway, I just spent 30 bucks on this game right before I did the community build. Wish I could take that back, but all that game's gonna do is go up in value. So there you have it, the community build. What I'm going to do is, in the description area of this video, I'm going to put a link on the best YouTube video that shows you exactly how to do it, that enabled me to do it. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed my little video here, and have a good day.